Thank God it's Friday, and you're welcome to another Celebrity Friday on Your View. I am Tokpe Mark Odige, and with me are my beautiful co-host. What's happening this Friday? I know that it is Jumoke that might have an interesting plan for this weekend. So, Jumoke.
Ah, hey, me. I'm just walking. Know. I've been dancing. I'm just a happy girl in a happy world. I'm very happy because family is all around. There's so much love and giving and laughing. People you haven't seen for years. I'm just so excited. Something else. We went for the Red Summit yesterday, and President Buhari was represented there by Shehu Gagba. I'm happy to be a youth, you know, that is doing great things to move Nigerian youth forward. And then I went to have my eyes checked. I do it once in 2 years, and I now have my glasses replaced. So I'm just a happy girl.
Nima, please tell me about this beautiful dress. And I'm sure your daddy will be watching, and I'll let him know now that.
My dad just came back. He just came back.
He just came back.
I'm a daddy's girl. No apologies.
You know you're a typical bush woman, so you can't even for now.
You see, no, they blend. You know, all I hear people do this is I'm like, okay, when you are done, call me. Because I don't know how to try to do. But daddy, thank you. This is a beautiful dress. I was able to at least get one. Because he shopped for only his grandchildren. But we thank
God.
This one is not my mother's size. Yes, thank you to Jumoke for suggesting the colorful pashmina I'm wearing.
It's beautiful.
Said I was looking dull this morning.
What are you, Ame? What are you doing this weekend?
Nothing much. Hopefully, I am planning to try to attend one of the weekend celebrations. Hopefully.
Oh, yes.
Because this is the celebration week. We've only attended the symposium.
Yes.
So we've not really gone to listen to the musical. I'm hoping maybe Sunday or Saturday night. Then also yesterday, I went to pick up my son from his class. There's a particular classmate that is always, anytime she sees me, I watched you on Your View. She now came and met me yesterday. My mommy has not been allowing me to watch Your View.
Oh, really?
You know, because I'm in school when it's happening in the morning. And when I come back at night, my mommy says it's too late.
Really?
I cannot watch Your View. And I said, oh, my darling, I hope you know that you're going to school. I hope you know that you have to wake up early tomorrow morning. So mommy understands that you need to wake up early. That's why she wants you to go to bed early. She was seriously reporting the mother.
I know.
I said, oh my.
I understand.
It was really interesting seeing her yesterday.
Someone asked me that, what would you call your target audience? And I said, really? The beginning of the show, we were targeting like 18 to like in the early 30s, 40s. I said, but right now we have grandparents watching. We have young children watching. Everybody
it's
finds the show interesting.
It's really, really nice.
But really, we're cutting across to the entire family.
Yeah.
So,
how was your day
We have a news mention.
How was your day yesterday?
Like, well, the day is the day now. For me, every day I just thank God. I wake up, I'm okay, I can eat, I'm happy.
Blackmail, you know, all this like.
Please. Well, today is World Food Day, and it is celebrated each year on October 16th with the aim of eradicating hunger in our lifetime. For me, this is really, really happy about it. We must remember that some people are hungry and are suffering.
And also for even mothers, you know, I always tell my children, people are out there, they are hungry, they don't have food to eat. So when you're given something, don't waste it, you know. And also, if you can, you know, try to be your brother's keepers. Take food out. Like we do that once in a quarter, I think. We do benevolence where we go give out food stuff and all that is important. And now we have entered the farming business. So hopefully when we start yielding, we'll also, you know, give out free food. I think it's very, very important.
Well, it's a fun ride on today's show. But first, we'll go through the front pages of the newspaper. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Welcome back. And we start the front page review with the punch. Monthly allocation not enough to pay salaries. That's from the governors. NNPC, NPA, all the dollar generating agencies under CBN probe. Falai, suspects reveal how ransom was shared. Total, Glencore, 99 others bid for NNPC contracts. Obalufe, head of Ife Kingmakers dies. Senate to screen Amechi, 8 others Tuesday. Consumer Protection Council raids multi-choice office. Ghana begs Nigeria not to cut gas supply. And finally, scores feared dead in Maiduguri mosque bombing.
We want to say rest in peace to the people who have lost family, to people who have lost their lives, and our condolences to the people who have lost family members in this mosque Kukuram. Bombing. Mm-hmm. It's so disheartening, and that I'm just hoping that by the end of this year, the federal government will, you know, do what they promised us to do and end insurgency in Nigeria.
I'm glad that we're having good signs, because this is how Boko Haram started. And if it's going back to how it started, it means that we're curbing them to some extent.
Yeah.
Because they're no longer taking over territories, but, you know, they're going back to suicide bombing, which is how they started houses. And trying to cause religious, cut across our religious lines.
Mm. And I have, two stories to take. Ghana begging Nigeria not to cut gas supply. That really stood out for me this morning, because there's a company that is called NGAS, comprises of Chevron, Shell, and NNPC. They supply gas to the western region, that's Togo, Benin, and Ghana. Yeah. And Ghana has about 70% of... they want to cut down 70% of the gas supply that they supply to Ghana, because they are owing them about $181 million. So these companies are collecting our gas, because the company is a power generating company. Mm-hmm. So providing power to your own state at the detriment, your own country at the detriment of us Nigeria. So I think but the Ghanaian president is saying that please they should try to resolve it and on. Let him just pay us our money, Sha.
We need the
money. If they are owing us, they should pay the money.
We really need the money.
Then this Consumer Protection Council, about multi-choice, you know, we've been having a lot of complaints flying around. They said the petitions that went on was that a lot of people having incessant disruption of, service without compensation, wrongful disconnection, service due to subsisting subscription, decoder swap, irregularities, poor readiness of mechanism.
Let me add
customer service wahala.
Let me add,
you know, so they are saying that now they have set up a panel.
We don't pay as you use. So, like, I don't get to put on the TV these days and it's reading.
What happened to me was that while still subscribed to them, I was cut off for a few days. I thought I had finished. I repaid and I was not brought back on. My husband said that no, we went back there and realized that we still had like 2 weeks and I wasn't conscious about it. And that was gone. I was told it was gone.
Now so they are doing their job. They are trying to investigate. A lot of people are being ripped off. And I don't blame multi-choice. I blame our own Nigerian, government. You know, because if you don't put in measures, these things will happen.
All right, moving on to the Nation. Major headline. Amaechi split Senate panel. Committee fails to write reports. Lawmakers get petition against female nominee. How agencies defraud governments by central bank. Police blame Navy, Air Force for Festac robbery. House clears 37 for commissioners, advisors in Lagos. Senate invites custom chief over rice importation. Oni's second in command dies at 85. And you can't miss the picture of Falaye, the suspects of Falaye's kidnap, that court remands 5 suspects in prison. Now, the story that jumps first at me is the police blaming Navy, Air Force for Festac robbery.
When I read that story this morning, I just felt, what is happening? We have the Area E command within Festac.
Command?
Just behind it, they are robbing. And you want to blame people? Although we have the naval barracks close by, but I don't see their vessels
anywhere. Let me tell you what their submissions were. They said that, listen, this thing happened. Do you know, I just realized that 15 years ago when I was in school, this same robbery has been happening for years. They come in through the canal, they enter, they said they called Navy. Mm-hmm. Navy said their vessel is too big enough to enter.
The one that is available.
Yes, the one that's available, that is too big. No, that even the smallest of their vessel is too big to go through that canal.
It's shallow then, waters.
Then the Air Force says that
they should call for,
because they called Air Force to trail the robbers
what
to that
to the marine police.
So what I'm saying is that, you know, the police have a role to play. I mean, the Navy have a role to play. The Air Force have a role to play.
The Nigerian police have a section called the Marine Police. They have a boat and they're supposed to guard internal waters. Mm-hmm. The Navy is for external waters. You can't blame people who are supposed to be defending the nation against external forces for something that is totally internal. That is just throwing blames around.
You. You know, when issues get like this, you tend to see blame game going around.
But you know, what I want to say is there should be communication between all parties and collaboration.
Before the police
would say that they called on the Navy and they called on the Air Force, you would also think that they don't have this equipment on ground.
I got first-hand witness reports.
Let me tell you, Nima. Hold on, Nima.
So let me
security,
hear
Nima's. Security is a, don't, because, you know, they stop my words. Security is a collective work. It is not for one person.
I agree
person.
With you. So it's, I mean, I it's agree with on. You, but from what we heard, first-hand reports, witnesses that were at the scene of the robbery said, the robbery went on for hours. You can't have the, it is a big slap in the face of the police to have the area command within a robbery scene, robbing area, and nothing happened.
Or a boat.
Or a boat.
That's
or
the
a
area boat. Command. All the way to Ajegule, all these people are under this area command. These people will be complaining to them about this kind of thing, not where the area command
we
is.
We have marine police and we have police helicopters, and we see them going around once in a while. I'm surprised that the command
will now be calling Navy and Air Force.
Any helicopter within their reach or marine police within their reach, considering that the police command E is within a riverine area, mile 2 is riverine, all those areas are very riverine. We need to move on though. But I want to just say something, that because we saw this happen in Lekki and in Ikorodu, there was response in Lekki. We now see that there are marine police patrolling the waterways. We need there to be changed.
Because people that live over there.
Yes. It must go round.
They should be better secure everywhere.
Moving on to Vanguard. Major headline. Falaye identifies kidnappers. 5 docked. 823,900 naira ransom recovered from suspect. I was expecting more than that though. Police recovered 137 million from fleeing robbers in Rivers.
Yeah.
First act robbery, area command transferred. Blame.
As usual.
More forex restriction coming November. That's not good news for business owners. Federal government probes agencies for remitting in naira, revenue realized in dollars. And finally, ministerial appointments. Again, Senate shifts Amechi Chitu screening. Now,
Tokwe, I want to pick on this Palace story. Mm-hmm. I'm happy that, you know, the police is really on the case. However, I went out yesterday and a young girl went to a salon. A young girl, they told us that she was going home and she was killed. She entered the bus and they cut off her genitals, they cut off parts of her body. It was a very sad story for me, because this is what I have been, you know, singing and shouting, that a lot of people that don't have big names are being kidnapped on daily basis. You know, and you now see one. I am happy that this is happening, but you see, what I want to say is that they should go beyond this. There are people that are dying every day. And they are saying that yesterday there was a robbery in Port Harcourt, and the police were able to round them up and they recovered about 137 million. So it's not like we don't have the capacity to actually kill this thing. You know, it's just the willpower, and to also realize that every citizen's life is important. Yes. Don't just focus on one particular person and solving that problem.
Another very important part of this arraignment that we had yesterday of the kidnappers, the abductors of Chief Falaye, is that we had some elements come out, because at the Celeberation, someone said, I don't even know when these people became the Yoruba leaders. I had never sat anywhere to decide who was my leader.
We didn't vote for them.
They came out to say, you know, it was an ethnic thing, trying to divide us along ethnic lines. It's very bad. Fani Kayode, his comments online were terrible, insisting these people were Fulani herdsmen. And the Fulani people kept saying they were not our people. If a group of boys come up together, are they the representative of these people?
No.
So it's wrong to, you know, generalize like that. It's very wrong.
What the article really said, I'm a little touched by the efforts of the Nigerian police and how they have done, you know, their job, particularly on this issue. Now, they've been arraigned in courts, which is, you know, the way it ought to be immediately. And the court has said, you know, remand them in prison for the time being. These people have denied, you know how they say, are you guilty? They said they are not guilty. But then again, they're saying that they can help the police to find their ogas. It's funny. Contradictory statements.
Moving on to Daily Sun. 2015 election. Buhari plots to stop me. President reveals Jonathan's desperate moves against him. New ministers, Senate defer further screening till Tuesday. World Ship Owners Association adopts Kalu as interim president. 2019, PDP zones presidency to North, splits over Muhazu. And finally, we were paid 100,000 each to kidnap Falaye. Suspects tell court remanded and also remanded in custody.
Have you read Summit yesterday? Shehu Garba was saying, because he represented the president, he told us how there would have been a coup by the former NSA, his second time, you know, denying the president his mandate, because they postponed the elections from February 14 to March 28 because they wanted to rig the elections. But he was saying that there was also an instance that they had said they were going to do something. Policemen surrounded the president's house as at the time he was an aspirant. He did not know what to do. But he called Debola Williams, who is a youth, and immediately everybody went on Twitter saying, this is what is happening at the president's house. He didn't come out of the house.
Just giving and credence to how the youth supported,
how the youth supported him. Yeah.
While expecting to see more youth nominees. I don't know when that will come up. We need to move on.
Just to make a joke, I asked Debola Williams, I expected to see your name on the nominees.
Me too.
And then he said, Jumoke, how would I have been competing with ex-governor Fashola for Lagos State?
All right, moving on to the Guardian. Again, National Assembly seeks President Assent to Constitution Amendment Bill. Lagos Assembly confirms list of 20 commissioners, 14 advisers. Buhari, neither a liberator nor national hero, says Nwabueze. Awo's wife convinced him to join my government, says Gowon. And finally, Ebola can persist in survivor semen for at least 9 months. That was interesting. We need to move on quickly to this day. How MDAs should change Nigeria by remitting dollar revenue in Naira. States, CBN bailouts insufficient to offset backlog of salaries. And another news, Senate Ethics Committee divided over Amaechi. Screening for ministerial nominees shifted to Tuesday. Saraki writes Buhari on confirmation of 18 ministers. 101 oil traders submit bid for offshore processing contracts. And finally, Constitution Amendment Bill to be retransmitted for President Assent.
I know now, we need to run off, but I quickly have to mention how Nigeria became a business for MDAs. That they would, you know, earn dollars. The NNPC, the Nigerian Ports Authority, and one other organization now, they would earn dollars, change it in the black market, and pay Naira into the Nigerian system. You know, with the exchange rate, they were making money
for them, a lot
off
of money.
Us. Well, you I'm know, happy so that basket has been locked.
Yes,
we and need the key thrown away.
We need to keep cutting off all these funds. We'll take a quick commercial break. When we return, we'll go through. We will be celebrating Fela. We will be celebrating. Yes, we're celebrating Fela.
Say yeah, yeah.
Stay with us. We'll be right back. Welcome back. Fela Anikulapo Kuti was known during his days as Nigeria's multi-instrumentalist, musician, composer, pioneer of the Afrobeat music genre, human rights activist, and political maverick. To commemorate the ongoing Felabration, we celebrate Fela as a true legend. Joining us to talk about Fela is Sandra Izsadore, who influenced Fela's music and ideology greatly. Please give us your view. Call us on 0780-8066-8014 and you could tweet to us at Yourview TVC. Sorry, at TVC _ENT, hashtag Yourview. We'd like to hear from you. Now, it is all about collaboration. All about collaboration. It's good to see you. You look beautiful.
Thank you.
You look
thank
really
you.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Welcome to Nigeria.
Again.
Right. And you know, I love Nigeria.
I
Nigeria to me is my African home. Because I am the first of my lineage to return here. So I'm very grateful to Fela for bringing me here to Africa. And when I returned, he brought me here to Lagos, Nigeria. So naturally, this is home. This is home.
So how much of Yoruba do you speak?
None.
But because we read a lot of profile about you on how you helped or you changed Fela's genre of music. So can you tell us a bit about that, how it happened?
Well, it was when he was in Los Angeles, and I met Fela. I heard the music, but I couldn't understand what he was saying. And at this particular time in America, it was a revolutionary period where blacks were becoming aware of their history and who we are as a people. So when I asked Fela what he was singing about, and he so proudly told me that he was singing about his soup. soup. So I said, no, you should use your music to teach and educate. And this is a way of informing the people. And I don't know, one of the things that I've seen that I really, you know, that disturbs me is the influence of the negative American music that has, it seems like it has flooded Nigeria. And that's not good. Because what America did, when they saw the power of the music, when they saw how powerful and how that music was empowering black youth, they had a meeting and they decided that it was too positive, that they needed to change. So this is when the floodgates of negativity came in and is taking over Nigeria.
Well, the thing is, this week has been dedicated to celebrating Fela. It's Felabration Week.
Right.
And it was his birthday yesterday.
It was his birthday yesterday.
Yes.
The idea has always been that people, like I said during the symposium, that I never got to have a one-on-one with Fela. I didn't experience Fela. What is Fela? The phenomenon, the legend, the Fela that came and sang songs that moved people to go onto the street. Who is that person to you?
Well, I can say that he was a phenomenal individual. As a matter of fact, so phenomenal. From day one, my life has not been the same.
Now, Nima, what's your experience? What do you know about? I'd like you to talk about Fela in terms of your experience with Fela. What do you know about his songs? How his songs influenced you? I know things. I don't want to just. I don't want to expose
my
you.
Nima,
lawyer.
But as a growing up girl, I had a lot of uncles living with us, and most of them were. I grew up in Surulere. I think the shrine then was close by. They were always there. So I had recordings of Fela's songs I would listen to with them. And as a young child, they didn't know. But I was getting attached to the music. And when everybody started moving out, I kept all their copies of their songs and all that. And I kept playing them. And my dad had to take them away. But what Fela's songs did for me was, at a very early time in my life, it made me start to think deep. Because, you know, it was totally different from the kind of things I was being exposed to by my parents. You know, and then someone is saying out there, Beast of No Nation, that kind of song, Egbe Kegbe and all that. I kept picking out those words and all that all the time from the songs. And my father was like, this girl is going to be rebellious. And I said, if you say anything to me, I'll question it. I would always ask a second question. You know, I don't just take things.
So Fela's music brought out you questioning the norm.
Yes. But you see, for me, Nima, Fela's music or Fela's ideology person, you know, from coming from the north, I don't know anything. You know, everybody just says Fela. So I thought also of this rebellious person. But when I look at his family, because that is the only connection I think I have with Fela. I look at YK, I look at Femi, I look at Chinua, I look at all of them. I see their family. You know, during Rolleri's wedding, you know, you see all the time that there's a family, there's any family event, there's holiday, they're all together, they're still loving bond. People. And they're people that, you know, you don't really see, it's not like rebellion. They just want things to be done right.
Thank
you know, it's not about saying you're being rebellious. You just see that this thing is not right.
Right.
So for me, that is, I think, that is my own, you know,
Fela experience.
Fela experience.
Jumoke, okay, yeah. I know you have Fela experience.
I do have Fela experience. And my first experience with Fela was having his music played all over. He was revolutionary in that he was an activist with his music.
Mm-hmm.
He moved people, you know, to do the right thing. Hence, he was arrested several times.
Mm-hmm.
You know, his house at Kalakuta Bond, you know. His mom, who was also an activist, killed in the process and all of that. But years later, as I grew older, I thought he was rebellious. You know, all the smoking and things that came with. But he was just standing out and saying that I don't care what you believe. The Christians have brought their Christianity from Italy and Rome. The Muslims have brought their religion and we've abandoned who we are. He was just being who he was, who he knew to be. And we've lost that now. Now everybody wants to sing like the Americans.
Like,
you cannot sound like them. You know, so Fela for me stood and personifies uniqueness, being comfortable in your difference.
And then another thing Sandra said that, you know, stands out for me is that what you get from this kind of negative singing is that you lose the ability to think deep, to question things.
Mm.
You know, you just want to have fun.
Just
you just want to shake,
want to make money
shake
anyhow.
Your bum bum and then be, you know, be everywhere so you can have selfies and all that with your words of dollars and all that and show off. Fela, back then, it wasn't exactly the, but everybody, it wasn't exactly rich. He had, you had no business going to him. It wasn't for favors, but people wanted to be close to him because, you know, they felt they could identify with him. He stood for something. He had an identity and people could identify
for the masses.
Well, Kayode has called in. Kayode, welcome to the show. Please give us your Fela experience.
I love Fela very, very much. Good morning.
Good morning.
My first time caller.
Oh, welcome to the show. Hello, are you there? Oh, we lost that call. Fela for me, and you know, like I said in the beginning of the show, I really never got to experience Fela until I met his family. Attending the symposiums and all that made me realize that, and being in the shrine, Fela is not, there's no pride. They are a very humble group of people. The ideology of Fela as a legend is humanism.
Right.
You connect with everybody. That person wearing rags, that madman would come and meet Fela and he will get a hug.
Right. Mm-hmm.
He would not be judged.
Not be discriminated.
You know? And I see that even in Rolleri, I see that in Made, that's Femi's son.
Yeah.
You see such love. You don't see pride. You don't see I'm superior to the next person.
Yes.
That genuine love is lacking in our society. That is why you will see kidnapping. That is why you will see someone use another person's child for ritualism.
Mm.
When you all see yourselves as one, whether I am a Kuti whose mother was the first person to drive a Mercedes Benz, and you are just a nobody living under the bridge, we are all one.
Yes.
And that was what Fela stood for. And he kept preaching it over and over again. We have another caller, and I'll just quickly... Let's hear your Fela experience. Welcome to the show. Good morning.
Good morning. Good
morning. Wale, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
Please, let's have your Fela experience.
I'm a first-time caller.
Oh!
We have a lot of first-time callers today.
Thank you very much. Let me begin with the comment. I don't know. Somebody made concerning the police that robbed the center. We should tell the IG to resign because the police force has everything to stand against the armed robbery. They have money, they have air force in the police force. So why are they not at work for 3 hours?
Don't mind them, Jerry.
The IG should resign. That's the most important thing. But concerning Fela for life, was a legend. Is a legend and will remain a legend. No one has been able to beat the standard in the whole of Africa and in Nigeria, most importantly. The music was unique, his message was direct. It was not a rebellious person, but it just stood out for something that no one has ever shown signs to believe in is a man of his own way. And that is one thing about him. No musician in the world today can preach such a message and face the military, face politicians, face everyone like it is. And that's why we remain a legend.
Thank you, Wole.
May I take a few
Thank you.
Seats?
I want to just I want to just get your another thing from you concerning Fela. I know that you sang on Fela with Fela.
Yes.
As a vocalist, you know, how was that experience?
It was good for me, and at the same time, it was a bit frightening because Fela had written these lyrics about his own country, and I'm saying to myself, how are the people going to love me and I'm standing here abusing their country, you know? But he stood in truth. And I think most of the problems in the world today have to do with the fact that we've been lied to. In school, you're not taught your story. No, you're taught his story, but you are not taught your story, our story. And we are connected, and we are family. In America, or any other part of the world, when you go, you're black. When they see this skin, when I identify with you, so I see you as brothers and sisters. I do not see ethnicity differences. You know, someone saying, well, I'm Yoruba, I'm Igbo, I'm Hausa, I'm Fulani. We're black. You know, we're born. And America will prove that to you. America will let you know that once you get there, and especially if you happen to be in the South, and you happen to be where the Ku Klux Klan live, the KKK, they will let you know. You could be from a royal line. But
well,
you're
black.
But you're black, and that's all they see. And they could be very poor. Another thing that I'd like to mention, which is true, Fela was the one who taught me when he came to America, he said this, every man is a king. So once he said that, then everyone, I view everyone as my equal. There's no status. I don't understand this. And what the world is now, what I see that's fearful for me is the danger that we're in.
Yes.
Self-destruction. And it's because the top is getting very heavy and it's starting to sway. And the bottom, what I have seen in America, the bottom supported the top. But every time they want to make a change, they go to the bottom and pull from the bottom. So the top is getting too heavy. And when the top gets too heavy, it's going to tumble.
There's going to be a problem. Yeah, we have a call from Babatunde. Welcome to the show. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning. Please, first-time caller.
Oh, welcome.
We have many first-time callers today.
Hello, Sandra.
Hi.
Nice to meet you. And I'm happy that you're reconnecting with your roots.
Yes.
So keep in touch. Africa is motherland.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, for Fela, I think it's our own philosopher. A prophet has no honor in his own. The way that like of Aristotle, all the international philosophers have been celebrated. I think Fela is our own philosopher. And if you reflect on all his music, what he has actually sang many, many years ago, we're still living with the crisis, the injustice in Nigeria. And what I want to tell the family, all his albums, they need to ensure that they document it and they ensure that it's actually intact for generations yet unborn. Fela is for today, it's for tomorrow, it's for the near future. I think Nigeria, we did not appreciate him. I remember there was a particular album. They were looking for it and they find it in Japan. So tell me that Fela actually called across the world. And I can say that he lived before his time and he's a great legend. And for Sandra, I have a souvenir that I will send to you to learn about Yoruba language. I have a book promoting Nigerian languages. I will send it to the beautiful ladies out there.
Okay, and she'll get
you. You can learn from our language. Okay. So you can now become a real Nigerian.
Send my own copy too. I want to learn the language.
All right. So,
may we take a few tweets? Honorable Kazim says, Fela was a great musician, teacher, philosopher, activist, and highly respectable Nigerian home and abroad. He lives on in my heart. Olufisayo Aramide says, Fela is a legend in Nigeria. Going against bad government, we will keep celebrating Fela till eternity. His Grace Toba says, Abamieda, today is your day. Yours is about speaking candidly, no holds bad. Yours is about sharing and living for the benefit of all. Busra Adeniji says, happy birthday to a great legend of freedom. So sad we didn't meet him, but his legacy lives on.
Franklin O says, Fela was an enigma, and his music remains relevant in our society. His songs of over 30 years still relevant in our society today. Mm-hmm. Ekong says, Fela's music is far politically inclined to the society than all this current rush-in, rush-out music of today. Mm. Kainde Balogun says, Fela Baba of religious teachings, yet he never belonged to any religion. A true cleric that never took tithe or any cathedral. Aliu says, Fela was a person that was daring to confront bad government, even powerful military government in Nigeria. He's a hero of democracy.
Another astonishing thing about Fela was that what we see now is when we see someone abuse our rights, like in Nigeria, everybody just goes, and you say, I leave you for God. Fela would speak out.
Left hand for God.
He would speak out about it. No matter how huge the forces are before him, he would stand up and, you know,
people
speak out.
People don't appreciate that anymore. You know, I hate injustice, for instance, and I would speak out for somebody that I think that is being cheated. And people say, Jumoke, what's your business? Why would shouting? You stop your car? Exactly. Why are you shouting? Why are you defending people?
Oh, now only you, Waka, come that kind
well,
of thing.
Well, Sandra, you did a song about Nigeria.
Yes.
And you shot a video in Nigeria. We'll be showing that video shortly. But can you just tell us what inspired or motivated you into doing that song?
Coming back in 2000, I think it was 2008, when I had the opportunity to come back, when I found out then that Snoop Dogg was going to be performing, and my husband just happens to be one of the top audio engineers in America, and he was doing a sound for Snoop at that time. I said, well, if you're going to Nigeria, I have to go. That's my home. You make sure I'm on that tour. And they made it happen.
Wow.
So this is how I was able to come back. And when I got back, I was really, really disappointed because I figured, you know, after so much information has been given, and Nigeria being such a wealthy nation with the most educated per capita people, with all the resources, why is Nigeria still at the footstool? And it was very disturbing to me because I believe so much in Nigeria. I believe that if Nigeria frees herself from the Western world, the rest of Africa could be free. I truly believe this. Nigerians are everywhere. Fela's music now, it may be coming down in Nigeria, but it's growing internationally. Internationally, it is being embraced. So you have this gold, these diamonds, and I mean in the literal sense that you have everything that you need, but you don't use it to your advantage. The money's in other banks around the world.
Really bad. We'll take that video right now. And then we'll let others see what it was about.
Rich land.
Fantastic.
Nice.
You know, I realize that listening to your song, you drop lines that will get you thinking. And I think that's what you say is lacking in the kind of music we're listening to right now. I also noticed that you tend to do your makeup, your dressing. Does this have anything to do with the revolution or
African?
I'm
embracing Africa. outfit that I'm wearing is an African designer in America. Mm-hmm. When I wear this, anywhere you go, they say, you're wearing Lon. They know him. Mm. Mm. Coming here, and I'm finding so many of the young men again, they're not emulating what they have. And in America, mm-hmm. we're sucking it up. Mm. And you don't really appreciate it. I find that there's not the appreciation and love that we have for it.
Mm. I listened to your song and, you know, you're talking about greed and all that. Surprisingly, yesterday I picked up a book. I was reading it and, you know, the biggest deposit of wealth and mineral resources are in the African terrain. Mm-hmm. We have everything in Africa. You know, so how, because I think our major problem is not that we lack these things. I think we need to transform our minds. Going back to what we had said earlier on, that, you know, when you don't see that this person is different, this mm-hmm. person is black, this person is from Igbo, this person is Edo, I have always been, you know, one to say on this couch that let us speak one language. Maybe that is when all this division will stop. But people say, keep arguing that we have a rich cultural heritage and blah, blah, blah. But, you know, how do you think Africans, we can transform our minds to become, you know, start thinking and seeing ourselves as one?
As one.
Where do you think we should start from?
Okay, very simple. If things are so simple, they're not complicated at all. One thing that I know that the Western world knows for sure, when you have division, you can conquer. Mm-hmm. When you have unity, you have strength. Mm. So to me, collectively, we can do more. We have, at the end of the year, there's a celebration called Kwanzaa, and it's one of the principles of Kwanzaa, collectively coming together, making things happen. And for the religious people, and you know, this was a shock to me, and in the beginning, I was wondering, how come Fela is so down on religion? Yeah. Well, I agree with him now. I'm a very spiritual person, but I don't want to be identified as Muslim, Jewish, Christian, Catholic, or Hindu, although I've studied all of them. And one of the things that there's over 42,000 different religions. Mm. 42,000. I'd rather be spiritual and read the word, because the Bible, the Quran, the Torah, those are very good books. And mm-hmm. they're very much in common. Mm-hmm. And if you live the principles
that are
the
in Bible, those books,
thank
you're good.
You will not have a problem.
We'll take a quick break right now. When we return, I'll ask you about your involvement with the civil rights movement. Stay with us. We'll be right back. She loves our song.
I love the rhythm.
Welcome back. Now, you were part of the very vocal civil rights movement. Between then and now, do you think we've really improved in terms of regards to race relations worldwide?
Yes. And a lot of that has to do, I don't know about here, but I know in America it has, because it's brought about awareness. And one of the things is here in Africa, another source of wealth that helped this communication to go internationally is the fact that coltan is mined here. Mm-hmm. Yeah. This is the only place in the world, in Africa, the continent itself, where you can get coltan. Mm. And now my realization comes that the Western world is dependent upon Africa. Why do you think there's such an interest here? Mm. Because the survival of the rest of the world is Africa, and you have everything and you're just frivolously throwing it away.
Sandra, please, sorry to take you back, because at the Celeberation you talked about the revolution in America and how the African-American had to find an identity, you know, and you know how you cherish what you have. Because I see Nigerians not knowing this, not knowing what it takes to finally get it. So they, you know, they don't know the value of what we have freely. But you had to struggle to get there.
Yes.
You know, people had to lose their lives, and you talked about Malcolm X and all the people that, you know, stood up for Africa and how someone tried to get Africans back to Africa, but they couldn't.
Right.
And, you know, and America stopped. I think you just take us down memory lane again on how, you know, what you guys did.
Okay.
And what you sacrificed.
First of all, his story does not tell you our story, because your ancestors and my ancestors were kidnapped, raped, and taken from this land by terrorists.
True.
The original terrorists.
True.
And after being taken abroad, our human rights were taken away from us. I don't know if the graphic pictures are there for you to see in his story what our story of black people hanging from trees. Nina Simone sang about it. Billie Holiday sang about it. We were abused. And even, okay, here's the thing. When black people were successful, the original the original Wall Street was Black Wall Street. And this was a black people in America that was very successful. They were so successful financially that the whites destroyed and burned down in Tulsa, Oklahoma. You can look that up. The original Wall Street was Black Wall Street. If you study his story, you will find our story, and you will find how instrumental the black African American has been in the development of all the inventions. And the reason why I say all of these inventions is because we were the slaves. So we were forced to have to learn how to make things.
That'll make you make the life easier for you.
But they took credit, the slave owners took credit for these things. So we need to study and delve into history. I was blessed enough that as a young child, the best things that my parents did was moving me as a small child into an all-white neighborhood.
So you the difference was clear. And you had to know yourself.
I did not know. I only had white playmates. So that's where the lessons began. And I started to see. I mean, I was like 5 and 6 years old. And I'm seeing, when I looked at TV, I only saw white people on TV. And if I did see black people, they were
Butlers.
Yes, butlers, maids. And they were always you know, buffoons. Hmm.
Oh, well, really, well, running out of time on the show today, and I'm really enjoying your story. However, I know that you're in Nigeria to commemorate Felabration, and I want to find out if you'll be performing at
she
any point
yesterday.
In time.
I was hoodwinked and bamboozled yesterday.
Oh, yes, so you performed.
I was captured. Oh. I'm on stage. I'm enjoying.
YK.
No, she didn't have anything to do with it. Let me tell you. There's this Chilean band.
Oh, okay.
They're from Chile.
Okay.
And like I said, South America, Fela. Look, so I'm just sitting on the side of the stage enjoying the music, and then they start playing Upside Down.
Oh. So you had to get involved.
And then I'm hiding in the, and they're like,
So you performed yesterday. Do you intend to still perform any other time?
I will be performing because I want to do Upside Down again. You know, that was recorded in 1976. I was a very young girl. So now I have to bring it a different way now.
Okay.
Not only that, I want to sing about what's going on in America. Because see, the things that Fela talked about and sang about in his song, at that time I thought it was exclusively Nigeria. Those chickens, Malcolm X said the chickens will come home to roost.
They have come.
You know what? So you plant a bad seed, that seed is gonna grow.
And then get back to you.
And here it is, here we are.
True.
And it's escalating.
So we're going to, well, in rounding off the show, because we're out of time,
we'll be listening to Fela's song. We're out of time, because I wanted to book you on your personal relationship with Fela.
Well, you're not going to talk about that one. Yes, we know something happened, but we're not going to talk about that. We're going to listen to Fela's song, and we'll round off on that. Go to YouTube and search for TVC Entertainment. Go through and you'll see Yourview. Also on Google Plus, you can search for TVC Entertainment and search for Yourview. The best cure for cancer is early detection. Get tested today. Join us next week for more on Yourview. Have a great weekend. Bye bye.
My name is Aniku Lakbo. I have death in my pouch. I can't die. They can't kill me. If you like it good, if you no like you hang, if you like it good, if you no like you hang, if you hang you go die, you go die for nothing. We go carry your body go police station, you die wrongfully. Gege, 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 gege. Man they suffer him no fit talk na condition. Man they suffer him fit talk na condition too. Man they suffer him no fit talk na condition. Man they suffer him fit talk na condition too. Suffer they Africa paparapa. I suffer day paparapa. Condition day paparapa. Me I no say you be African man, and we they suffer paparapa. Which condition you day I don't know. The condition me I day me I know. My condition don't reach me, make I act. Oh! If your conditions today make you shake and you still did not talk the way you feel. Make you open your two ears very well to the yard to talk way yeah they talk. Listen, make you they grieve for me every day and night today, yeah me talk. One day you self go grieve with me to the act the way as you they feel. Remember if you don't act your own, one day of course we must die. Nigeria get the money, foreign money for hope I see. Nigeria get the money, foreign money for hope I see. Announcements start to happen, newspaper carry them paper. Radio they shouting for us to do. Obasanjo calling vocalist, Yaradua road the manager. Every government.